Before we get into the video, I just want to give a shout out to my boy Saj. The link to his channel is below in the description. Alright, as some of you guys may know, Demon Slayer RPG 2 just dropped a fat update today. They dropped the new Blood Demon art by the name of Hantengu, I believe. I don't want to butcher the name, but it's called Hantengu. And I'll just be doing a quick showcase of all the moves in this video. And just a side note, it does have a lot of moves, and they are all OP in their own rights. And I'll also be doing a quick little 1v1 match, just to see how it copes in an actual fight. And yeah, let's just get into the video. Okay, so starting off, I just want to get the pose out of the way. So this is the pose for the Hantengu Blood Demon art. It's pretty simple, it's just a hand almost covering the face. And so this Blood Demon art has two forms. It has the base form and it has a weapon form, which is like a spear. I just want to get the base form done first, and then I'll move on to the second form. So the first form consists of four moves, E, R, T, and Y. The E move does this. It's a sort of roar, and you can aim it even if you miss, so it's movable. And how this works is, let me just look. So if you roar from a distance, it doesn't block break him. However, if you come up close to him, like very, very close, so you have to come up very close to your opponent to hit this, it does actually block break. So yeah, it's pretty OP in that regard. So M1, M1, M1. Bam. Just knocks the opponent away. It's pretty OP. Alright, so the second move is R, and this summons a sort of shadowy looking move, which I think it basically gives you iframes. And this move is the hardest to hit out of all the moves that this Blood Demon Eye has, since you have to come up proper close to your opponent. So, right, just PB. So, M1, M1, M1. And R. So, that's one way to use it. The second way to use it is, let's just wait for the cooldown. So R, and then you can do extra damage right now. So it basically holds your opponent in place, and you can deal extra damage using M1s. It can be pretty OP and pretty toxic, since it gives you iframes. And yeah, that's the second move. Okay, so the third move is T. And this basically summons this sort of whirlwind that sucks your opponent in. So let's just test it. This is this move is actually long range, so you can use it to suck people in. So as you can see, he comes right up to you and then you M1 him. And much like the first move, the raw move, you can actually aim the R move, the T move as well. So as you can see, you can aim it. So it's very useful in that regard. And again, let's just see if it block breaks. If this block breaks too, I'll be surprised. Okay, this is pretty broken. I feel like Hikoshi's gonna nerf this Blood Demon art at some point. I think he just made them all block breakers to see how well this Blood Demon art does, and then make adjustments to it. So everything that you see now will probably be different in the future, but yeah, enjoy it while you can. Okay, so the last move in base form is a move that summons a weapon. Let me just show you guys. So this is Y, by the way, and it summons this sort of spear looking weapon. For starters, it gives you a better M1 range, so it's pretty busted. And much like the other Nishirin swords that slayers have, it actually sucks your opponent in, so they can't escape from your M1s. So another example of it, of the opponent getting sucked in, is as you can see, he just comes to you. So it's pretty useful. I think right now this is the longest M1 weapon in the game. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Okay, so the second thing is this move, the Y move that we just used, changes your whole moveset. And it's pretty OP, I can't lie. So it changes E, R, T, all of them, it changes it. So let's just see what the E move does. Okay, so the E move does this sort of mini barrage, as you might call it. And it's pretty OP because you can M1 right into it. So, oh, missed it. Oh, let's just try that again. I think you have to M1, 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 and then do the E move. So, M1, M1, M1. Yeah, that's pretty OP. I can see this being like a good finisher or like a quick little combo to basically extend upon. So yeah, that's pretty OP. So the next move is the R move. This is personally my favorite move, since it has such a low cooldown and it does so much damage. So bam. It's actually so sick. So let's just see one more time. And it does block break, as you just saw there. I don't think I covered the block break for the E move yet, so let's just see if the E move block breaks. Okay, so the E move doesn't block break. If the E move did block break, then that would just be busted for no reason. Because that's just not fair. So I'm gonna do the R move one more time. By the way, you can actually aim the R move, so you can land wherever you want. You can land backwards, forwards, to the side. So I'm just gonna quickly showcase that. So as you saw there, I jumped and then sort of guided my cursor to where I want to land. There's actually a way to extend the distance at where you jump, which I've done many times by accident. Sometimes it doesn't work, sometimes it does. So what you have to do is basically run and then dash, and at the same time you dash, you click R, so you go flying and then use the R move. I can try to do it right now, but it's sort of chance based. Yeah, it didn't work there, but it works sometimes, very rarely. But yeah, so the final move is the T move, and this works the same way as the whirlwind did in the base form. So yeah, it works the same way, except it doesn't bring your opponent to you. Instead, it flings them away. So it's more like an evasive move to get out of combos, stuff like that, to get your opponent far away. And finally, the Y move, it removes your weapon. So it's pretty simple, pretty busted moveset. I still need practice with it, I'm not quite good with it yet, since I just got it. But yeah, let's just test it out in PvP and see how it copes in a match. Alright, so now we're going to just test it in a PvP match. And it's going to be best out of 3, just to give me a bit of more of a chance, since I'm quite new to this problem now. But yeah, let's just get started. Alright, so currently in base form, I'm going to try my best to commentate on 1v1. It's going to be pretty hard. By the way, he does have explosion, so this is going to be pretty hard. Got him. Okay, so M1, M1, M1. R. Extra damage. Smash. And then for me. I think I missed that. Oh, it's whatever. Man, when did explosion get so busted? Maybe I'm just bad. Right, so let's just try to get this. Once I land the whirlwind move, it's actually pretty much over. Got him. Smashed out. Alright, I think now's the right time to get my other form out. Got him. Alright, so M1. Oh. Almost got it, wait. Almost smashed out. Damn. Alright, that's pretty OP. I'm not sure if I landed that. Once, I'm telling you, once I get this weapon form out, it's over. Oh, PB'd. I hope I don't jinx myself. Alright, GG's. That's round one. Man, I can't lie, explosion is pretty OP. Alright, so now it's round two. Let me just do the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. And again, I'm starting off in base form again. So, suck him in. M1. Smash down. Right, that was pretty sick, I can't lie. Right, so let's think of what I'm gonna do for the next move. Explosion has such a big hitbox, so it's hard to do the move sometimes because my whirlwind gets cancelled. He dodged it. Raw move comes in so in clutch sometimes. Smash down. I love that move, it goes flying. Rowing. Smash down. I'm surprised this demon art even... Yeah, he went flying. I'm surprised this demon art even went this far and beat a explosion user, because I'm telling you right now, like, this demon art is on par with Akasa. It could potentially be on par with Akasa. Because Akasa right now, I think it's the meta and it's the most OP blood demon art at the moment. I would argue like explosion or swamp would be a runner up, almost on par with Akasa. But I think like for new demon art, I don't think this is this bad. I think we just have to wait for the patches and the nerfs, and then we can see where this demon art truly stands. Right, so this is the final round. We switched to land just to change things up a bit, change the environment around so we can use the trees to advantage or something like that. But yeah, let's just count down again. 2, 1, go. Smash. That's actually so good. Let's get the weapon out. Bam. Dang it. Oh, this is quite hard to learn. Switch back to baseball because I feel like baseball might be better. Dang it. Alright, so final round. Explosion wins. I think that's pretty fair. I mean, overall, this demon art won 2 out of 3 rounds, so I think that's pretty good. Let me just reset. Oh, I can't even reset. Right, so now we have reached the end of the video. I think a lot of you will have the same question. Should you get this demon art? I would say yeah, just go for it, because I think it is very, very good. It has a lot of potential. It could be one of the best demon arts in game right now, just purely because of its combo potential. Again, in the future, this can all change, since Higoshi can make changes and nerfs to it. But yeah, as of right now, this demon art is one of the best. The effects are clean. Every single move has a purpose for it. And yeah, overall, a really solid red demon art. So yeah, good job, Higoshi. Good job, staff team. And see you in the next video.